Students, today we are going to discuss about nanotechnology. In the present days, most of the objects or the things or the innovations is going to be the size matters. That means day by day we are seeing that the new appliances or new technical gadgets we are getting with the smaller objects, the small in sizes. That means, I will give you the best example. In the olden days, nowadays we are using the mobile phones. That present days, you are observing very, very thin mobile phones that you can capable to hold the mobile phones, the screen also. So that much of technology you are using nowadays. When comparing with the old days, means old days means previous 5-6 years back, at the time of cell phones are introduced in the market, that normal cell phone size is seems to be a weight of minimum 400 grams weight with a big object. Like it seems to be a satellite phone, seems. But nowadays we are using all the touchscreen mobiles with all HD cameras, with high resolution, with foldable screens and everything. What happens here, the size is going to be reduced, as well as the working performance is also enhanced. So here, such type of technology is possible with the help of nanotechnology. There is a most advanced research is going to be happening in the today's world. That we are day by day, so many works, so many challenges we are facing. And we are doing such advanced research for the nanotechnology. Now, here I'm mentioning some of the application scenarios where you are observing all these nanotechnology. So here you are observing all these smaller glass jars carries different colored liquids. Actually, what happens here, how you are getting the different colors of light. So here the light emission of from the particular color particles depending upon the size matters. So here you can observe nano crystals absorb light, then re-emits the light in a different color. So here the different color means that different color value depending upon the size of the nano crystals. Means one type of color, here you may take a red color. So here you can observe this red color, the all incident light is seems to be blue color, but the output color is different for different sized particles. If you are taking very smaller particle size particles, there you are getting output light as a blue color. If the size of the particle is bigger, then you are getting a red color light here. That means the color of the material or color is emitted by the particular particles are affected by its size. And one more example, at the time of initial times, you are using SIM cards in the mobile. So this is the 2G SIMs. Actually, you may know 2G, 3G, 4G SIMs. In the 2G SIMs, you may have the mini SIM, which is a dimension of 25 mm to 50 mm dimensions. Now, after introduction of 3G technologies, now the SIM size is also reduced to micro SIM. The size value, the height of the SIM was reduced to 25 to 50, and nearly half of the value was reduced. And the length value also 15 to 12 mm reduced. Next, presently we are using nano SIMs, mostly we can call it as a 4G SIMs for your understanding purpose. And the size again reduced, 12.3 millimeters to 8.8 millimeters. Here, the size reduction is happening in the case, as well as the performance of this particular materials also enhanced. So, మన 2G SIM లో తీసుకున్నప్పుడు ఎలా ఉంటుంది, 3G SIM కొన్నప్పుడు నెట్ యాక్సెస్ ఎలా ఉంటుంది, 4G SIM కొన్నప్పుడు
just the performance I'm tracking. The size matter means once you are reducing the sizes, but it not affects its properties. Always you need to enhance their properties. So such type of enhancement we are observing in the nanotechnology. That's what everyone referring to deal these nanotechnology because of the improvement in the properties of the material. That's what it plays an important role in the present modern technological lives. So these are some other examples. As I mentioned, no? So foldable display units, our cell phone, mobile phone screens also having a capability of rolling. Okay, like a liquid crystal displays, LED displays. So that can be possible with the help of nanotechnology. And there you may have the carbon nano tubes. These are the carbon nano tubes. These two. Actually, the thickness, nano means the size value is 10 power minus 9. Very, very low values. Once you are preparing the size of the material in nano means you can't identify the sizes are directly with our human naked eyes. And in that case, if you are preparing such a type of nanotubes, what is the preference of this nanotube? Here, these nanotubes also, you can observe here, it seems to be Buckminster Fullerene C60 type structures you are observing here. And in this all are carbon materials. Carbon already, you know, they are covalently bonded. Strong molecules are there in the carbon nanotubes. Once you are rolling these carbon nanotubes in a cylindrical manner, in a size of nanomaterial sizes, at this particular situation, you have very strongest bonding between the carbon particles. Then the mechanical property of this particular carbon nanotube is very much improved. Means very strongest object, it seems to be. So such type of properties that you are observing for these carbon nanotubes, they are having a good number of mechanical properties. In mechanical objects or any new type of materials, the scientists are preferring these carbon nanotubes in the present days. And this can be possible for the nanotechnological scenarios. So here we are observing one more application part. There, water repellent cloths. Actually, this is the optimum technology. Here also we are covering the total cloth with the nano sized particles. So we are having a capability of repulsion of water particles. Like what we mentioned is a hydrophobic natures. So these cloths are hydrophobic natures. So they can't absorb the waters. Like here also, the shoes. Once you are pouring any liquid or objects in the shoes, it will not absorb those water particles. And for the case of hearts, means here we are doing in the medical purpose also, we are supplying the medicines in the nano sizes to reach the particular areas. And this is the one of the best example. In the old days only, they invented such a type of glass materials. In the era of Greeks, they invented such a type of glass. There it can emit a different colors of lights. When you are pouring hot water, when you are pouring cold water in the particular glasses, it will emit different colors depending upon the situation where you are using. If you are pouring hot water, it will give you red color. If you are pouring cold water, it will give you the blue color. So how it is possible? Because of the first property that we discussed, no? So depending upon the particle sizes, they can emit. So here you are pouring the hot water means there the temperature matters. But the variation in the temperatures, the properties of the particles in the particular glass materials varies. So that you are getting different color of light which is emitting So that means it's not a new technology. It's already there in the human era. Now we are introducing the concepts with the high number of enhanced application scenarios for your upcoming modern daily life situations. Now, in our general knowledge, you can say that the thinnest object is human air. So human air means you may take a single human air, the thickness of the air is about 0.1 mm. That means 100 micrometers. That you can convert into nanometers. It's a 100,000 means nearly 10 lakhs nanometers. That means it's a big number. But according to the our human, human psychology or human understandable manner, the thinnest object we can say it's a hair. But you are representing the numbers into the nanometers, but it's not comes under the category of nano sizes. Actually, 1 nanometer is the 10^-9 meters, the smallest object. But here, the values, what we are showing here, somewhat huge values. So, according to our knowledge, you can have a comparison between this one. So here, the human hair is about the size of 0.1 mm. When compared to the red blood cells that are present in the blood, there the size of the one red blood cell is about 6,000 nanometers. From 10 lakhs nanometers in Japan, now it is about 6,000. That means very smaller. Again, you may have this diagram that is a DNA. That is a DNA. The DNA of a human body. They are present in the cells. It is about 3 nanometers. So comparing with these three categories, which one belongs to the nano-sized particles? Here, obviously, you can say DNA belongs to the nano-sized categories. Remaining more than here, you are saying the numbers in nanometers, but it not comes into the category of nano-sized particles. Without any doubt, we can say DNA size is in the range of nanometers. So this DNA only exhibits the or comes under the category of nano-sized objects. Remaining in numbers, we are saying, but it's not comes under the categories. Why? Because nano-sized particles means which size comes under the category of nano-sized means 1 to 100 nanometer size particles only comes under the category of nano-sized. If it is more than 100, it's not comes under the category of nanometers. According to the numbers, I'm saying here I'm showing these numbers in nanometers, but that is not the range. The range is 1 to 100 nanometers particle sized particles. We can say it is a nano sized particles. Beyond that, we can't. So this red blood cell here, even though it is smaller, but it not comes in the category of nano-sized particles. Now, this is the human hair. You are observing this. This one is the human hair. As I mentioned, it's about 10 lakh nanometers. Now, coming to this nanofibers. Fiber means it also seems to be like a small wires. When you can say it is a normal nanofiber wires, there the thickness you can compare the clear sizes of this particular objects here. They are very, 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 very thin. How much it is? 10^-9 meters. 10^-9 meters. So comparing with this human hair, that human hair also you can see it is a bulk object. Big sized object. So human hair, even to our eyesight, you can say it is a very smaller object. But coming to the case of nanotechnology, it's not a nano sized object. When you can say if the size of the object is less than 100 nanometers, then only you can say it is a nano sized object. This is the actual scale. which materials we can call as nanometers. So football having a size of 22 centimeters, like mosquitoes you may take, it is a size of 1 millimeter. Coming to the red blood cell, as I mentioned, 7 micrometers. Virus, which are present on the water, the smaller objects, they are in the size of 150 nanometers. Here you can observe 150 nanometers. But coming to the buckyball, this Buckminster Fuller in C60, as I mentioned, the size, it also seems to be a football. First one is also football, last one also football. But what is the size of the object? Football size about 22 centimeters. First, buckyball size, Buckminster Fuller in C60 size is about 0.8 nanometers, that is the size. We required that much of size. 0.8, it is less than 1 also. Okay, and diameter of human hair, 80 micrometers. And titanium oxide in sunscreen lotions, like you are using that Fair and Lovely, Fair and Glow, yes, powder, face powders. There you are using the titanium oxide, okay, particularly in the sunscreen lotions. You are getting very shiny skin now, so because that shiny skin is possible with the addition of titanium oxide in the particular gel. Okay, so there you need to mix a titanium oxide with the size of 35 nanometers, and the thickness of human DNA is about 2 nanometers. Now comparing all these concepts, these three diagrams, means buckyball, titanium oxide, DNA, are only comes under the category of nano sized objects, remaining or not. Okay, so they are, when comparing with all these three particles, they are very big size objects. Even for our human knowledge, you can say 7 micrometers is a smaller one, but it's not a smaller value when it comparing with the nanotechnology or nano sized objects. They are also very big values. Micro means 10 power minus 6. Here nano means 10 power minus 9. Still a 1000 difference, means a 0.001 difference value is there. So that is a very big number for the sized objects. Now, what is nanoscience and what is nanotechnology? So, even any unknown person you may take, they can think they have a thought that both are same. Nanoscience and nanotechnology, both are same. But there is a difference between nanoscience and nanotechnology. So, what is nanoscience? Nanoscience, the study of phenomena and manipulation of materials at atomic, molecular and macromolecular scales, where the properties differ significantly from those at the larger scale. The study, so you need to study or you need to observe the variation of the properties from the atomic level, molecular and macro molecular level cases, particles yokka materials yokka properties ela study chestamo ani dani gurinchi discuss chesedi nanoscience. And nanoscience is the study of understanding the properties of nanoparticles. Coming to the nanotechnology case, the shape and size at a nanometer scale, it is a design, characterization, production and application of structures, devices and systems by controlling. So shape and size at a nanometer scale, it is the design, characterization, production and application of structural devices and systems by controlling. That means here you are going to preparing the material. Technology means using those devices, using those instruments, you are going to prepare, you are going to study, you are going to characterize those materials by controlling its size. That means they are the man-made. Technology is nothing but man-made. So by controlling their shape sizes, you are going to prepare such type of nano sized particles. Then they are coming under the category of nano technology. So here, nanomaterial. Nanomaterials could be defined as the materials with at least one its dimensional in the range of nanometer. What is the range of nanometer? 1 to 100 nanometers. Then only we can call it as a nanomaterial. Does the material need to be a small that it can't be seen? It can be larger surface or a long wire whose thickness is in the scale of nanometers. That means what it can say here, you are taking a one-dimensional nanomaterials. So there, does a material need not to be small that it can't be seen? It can be larger surface or long wire whose thickness is in the range of nanometers. Thickness. ఇక్కడ మనం ఏం చెప్తున్నాం అంటే మెటీరియల్ నీడ్ నాట్ టు బి స్మాల్. మనం తీసుకున్న మెటీరియల్ చిన్నగా ఉండాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు, అన్ని కూడా కంటికి కనపడాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. ఈవెన్ దో యూ కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ ఎస్ నానో మెటీరియల్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పాసిబుల్ ద థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ద మెటీరియల్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ద రేంజ్ ఆఫ్ నానో మీటర్స్. అంటే మనం తీసుకున్న మెటీరియల్ మన కంటికి కనబడుతుందా? ఓకే, చిన్నగా లేకుండా పెద్దగా ఉన్నా మనం దాన్ని ఎప్పుడే నానో మెటీరియల్ అంటాం. The thickness of the material in the nanometers, then only you can say it is a nano-sized object. The materials that are nanoscale in one dimension are nanowires and nanotubes layers. Actually, manipur ikkada three dimensional lo unnatundi different nanometers are existing. One is single dimensional, 2D, two dimensional, three dimensional. So if you are considering a material in one dimensional, you can call it as a nanowires and nanotubes. If the materials are said to be in two dimensional, which are in the thin films or surface coatings. Surface coatings means, like the best example like I mentioned as a spray paint. మనం vehicles కి లేకపోతే old days లో మనకు మిషన్ ద్వారా స్ప్రే పెయింట్ చేస్తుంటారు. Only on the surface of the material you are spraying the colors, and thickness of the spray painting is in the range of nano sized objects. There you have the two dimensional nano objects. Now the third dimensional materials that are in nanoscales in three dimensional are particles, for example precipitates, collides and quantum dots. Three-dimensional objects, we have length, breadth, and height values. The examples are precipitates, collides, and quantum dots. They are comes under the category of three-dimensional quantum nano-sized particles. So zero-dimensional, one-dimensional, two-dimensional, three-dimensional. So sphere, zero-dimensional means sphere. Only single tiny dot, one dimensional sheets, two dimensional tubes, three dimensional that interconnected architecture. The properties of the nanomaterials. Now, after reduction of the sizes, mainly the properties of the nanomaterials are going to be affected. So nanometal properties are different from the bulk materials. Why? Once you are reducing sizes, no? Because in the process of reduction of its size matters, the properties of the particular particles are going to be varied. So those properties you need to study. What are the main affecting categories and what are the properties are going to be varied. So most nanostructured materials are crystalline in nature and they possess unique properties. So మనం తీసుకున్నటువంటి నానో మెటీరియల్స్ అన్ని కూడా మాక్సిమం ఎలా ఉంటుంది, క్రిస్టలైన్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో దే ప్రొసెస్ యునిక్ ప్రాపర్టీస్. దట్ ఈస్ ద బెస్ట్ అండ్ ఫస్ట్ ఫార్మోస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఎవ్రీవన్ షుడ్ రిమెంబర్, దట్ ఈస్ once we are preparing nanomaterials, they are having unique properties or enhanced properties also. Sometimes it exhibiting. So here, what are the properties are going to be varied? They are physical properties, chemical properties, electrical properties, optical properties, and magnetic properties. So these are the properties are mainly affected by the size of the particular material. Once you are preparing different size particles, obviously due to the reduction in sizes, these properties are also going to be varied. The physical properties of the nanoparticles, crystal structures of nanomaterials, crystal structures of nanomaterial nanoparticles is same as bulk structure with different lattice parameters. The interatomic spacing decreases with size, and this is due to the long range electrostatic forces and the short range core repulsions. So here, once the physical properties affected, the melting point of the nanoparticles decreases with size, because while you are reducing the sizes, so here the first and foremost point you should know is why these properties are varied. These things first of all you should know. The principal factors cause the properties of nanoparticles differ significantly from the other materials. The first one is increased relative surface area. Second one is quantum confinement effect. These two factors affects the total properties of the particular material. So enduku change avutundi ante ee two properties vary avadam valla manaku maximum of properties anni kuda change avutundi. So aa properties ఏంటి అంటే ఎఫెక్ట్ అవుతుంది టోటల్ సర్ఫేస్ వాల్యూమ్ రేషియో అంటే సర్ఫేస్ వాల్యూమ్ రేషియో ద సెకండ్ వన్ ఈస్ క్వాంటమ్ కన్ఫైన్మెంట్ ఎఫెక్ట్ సో వాట్ ఈస్ సర్ఫేస్ వాల్యూమ్ రేషియో సో హియర్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు హియర్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు reduce the size of the particular material. So what happens here, this is the 1 meter, so you are cutting the cube into smaller objects. So here what happens, the number of particles in the objects are coming out the surface. That means the total particles at the time you are reducing the sizes, the particles on the surfaces are more, so that they are highly effective, highly interactive. So here the causes variation in the sizes. So this is the bulk size. Once you are reducing the sizes, when it comes to the lower size, the number of particles on the surface also is going to be increases. So here you can check surface volume ratio 2, here surface volume ratio 3, here is the surface volume ratio 6. Okay, in this case only two particles are maybe present on the surface. In case no, three particles. In case no, six particles are present over the surface. So that what happens, they are present on the surface, six particles, they are very highly reactive surface. So avvothundi six particles ekkuva unde sari vaatapadu high reactive untundi, idu deentona bonding chesukunna, deenika a share chesukolanna chala readily available. అందువల్ల ఈ ప్రాపర్టీస్ అన్ని మెయిన్గా ఎఫెక్ట్ అయ్యేది సర్ఫేస్ వాల్యూమ్ రేషియో వల్లనే మనకి ఎన్హాన్స్మెంట్ అనేది ఎక్కువగా ఎగ్జిస్ట్ అవుతుంది. ఓకే, సో దట్స్ ఇట్ ఫర్ టుడేస్ క్లాస్. రిమైనింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ వేర్ గోయింగ్ టు డీల్ ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.